Mr. Gianni Infantino in Doha. And we did agree in my meeting with Mr. Infantino that today, Monday, the 28th, official communication will be issued to myself and by extension to the Football Kenya Federation, FKF. And indeed, that communication has since been received by myself and by FKF. Allow me, just for the record, to read this letter that arrived this afternoon from Doha, Qatar, where FIFA has been treated for the length of the currently ongoing 2022 World Cup. The letter is titled Lifting of the Suspension of the Football Kenya Federation. Remember, it's the federation that is a member of FIFA. It's the federation that had been the face of the suspension. And once the federation is suspended, it's really the country under suspension. FIFA is saying that it would like to inform you that the situation of the FKF was submitted to the Bureau of the FIFA Council for consideration and decision on November 25th. That is last Friday. That's the day I held my meeting with the whole FIFA leadership, led by the FIFA President Gianni Infantino, General Secretary Padma, and other officials of FIFA. That meeting was also attended by the leadership of CAF, the organization responsible for football in Africa, led by President Hotsepe. FIFA 2022, the General Secretary, General of FIFA, confirming that the Kenyan government, as represented by the newly appointed Cabinet Secretary for Sports, the Honorable Babu Mwamba, and reinstated the FKF Executive Committee with immediate effect. The Bureau also noted that the FKF General Secretary further asserted that the FKF offices have been handed back to the Association Selected Leadership. In view of these circumstances, the Bureau of the Council decided on November 25th, 2022, to lift the suspension of the FKF with immediate effect. Upon the lifting of the suspension, a FIFA CAF mission will be deployed to Nairobi in order to define the next steps for the FKF and also to meet with the newly appointed Cabinet Secretary for Sports. Further details will be communicated accordingly and in due course. Finally, the lifting of the suspension of the FKF takes place without prejudice to the ongoing investigations and court proceedings at national level. We thank you for taking note of the above and welcome this positive outcome. You are respectfully, Fatma Samura, Secretary General of FIFA. You will delight. My delight for this position. My delight for Kenya returning back in the fold of international football. I want to confirm that on that date of November 25th, last Friday, I had very fruitful discussions, one-on-one, with the FIFA president and his team. I want also to confirm that I have also indicated to FIFA that the government of Kenya is keen, extremely keen, on certain substantive developments. Number one, we are very keen to launch a program for talent, sporting and talent development. And so you are going to see a lot of action in terms of grassroots development. You are going to see a lot of work going on around the Kenya Academy of Sports. Today, the Kenya Academy of Sports is only an academy. It is not an academy that you can look at. It's a platform for developing talent. But very soon we are launching something mega. I'll be inviting you to a mega launch where we are launching a program on how to support and develop talent. We have the Vision 2030, and at the very minimum, Harambe Stars must play at the World Cup 2030. That is the minimum. If we can make it to the World Cup 2026, that would be great. But we are being realistic that with good investment in good planning, with investment in talent development, and running our football in a manner that is transparent, accountable, and with tenets of good governance, we can get Harambe Stars in the World Cup 2030. While in Doha to meet FIFA and CAF, I took time to watch a number of games. And from what I saw, that is a state I want to display my talent. It is sad that commitment number one, I gave my word that I'm going to consult stakeholders within the sporting arena for us to start solving issues that have really hindered the development of career sports. And I've been doing that from day one, since I entered this office. Number two, I promised the people of Kenya that I will prioritize the lifting of the FIFA suspension of Kenya. I'm very happy that as I finish my first month in office, I have managed to get this suspension lifted by being in constant touch with FIFA and taking the effort to personally travel to Doha to hold the meeting that finally unlocked this campus. But also, yes, we are back in the good ways of FIFA, but we must go back to the process. We must develop talent. We must select national and on merit. Hii mambo ya kwamba unacheza because you are a friend of the FKF or because you are a friend of the country secretary, hiyo ni mambo sasa imepita na wakati. We want to select our national teams on merit and transparently so that when we announce the national team, even you people in the media, you can sit back and say, yes, this is a deserving national. So there are many things which we are going to be doing, and the good thing is that now we have a platform to start. I'm just happy that I have fulfilled my promise to you guys. Celebrating the lifting of the FIFA ban, now you are asking me doping. World athletics, rugby, but I'm not complaining. It's a job we have to do, and we'll do it.
Yes. We appreciate the situation of the and we appreciate that the information has helped. The issue of rugby, at least we expect you to talk about maybe there's some progress in terms of setting them something, even as they did something their own.
I am handling that. Yeah. I'm handling that. I've been on these maps since morning. When I woke up at 4 in the morning to go to Mutihani, musicians, but I have my hand on all this in good hands. So we have had a very good meeting on rugby. I have something to report to you on rugby. But why don't you just allow me to take in the pleasure of football? Okay. Allow me to enjoy the football moment. In 20 minutes, I'll do rugby.